Welcome back to the charismatic voice. Leia Salonga is the voice of not one, but two Disney princesses, both Jasmine and Mulan. If that alone doesn't convince you that her voice is worth analyzing, today's video will. I have seen this one many, many times, but I want to bring it to you because I think that this performance is the perfect blend of emotion and vocal technique. Let's get to it. We're going to go back to the beginning. You're not surprised, right? She hasn't even started singing yet, but I want to put in a little comment here about how incredible Les Mis is. This musical is incredibly touching. They've made a video of it. Yes, you should watch that too, but go watch some other versions as well and see all of the different characters, how they're portrayed by different people. Here, Leia Salonga is going to be portraying Eponine, who's incredibly lovable and tragic and strong, just amazing. I love the way in this first bit, we're having this entrance from a lot of very big moments, and we have to have instrumental transitional material to bring us into this very vulnerable moment for this character. And it is done so well. It captures our attention and our energy right away, and then funnels it into this magnifying glass for this incredible moment. So just listen to how the orchestration of it does that, how the keys of it goes from big minor to a more major feeling, a little more hopeful feeling. There's so many elements that make this transition huge and perfect. Draws you in right away. We had lots of winds, horns, timpani in there, and now much lighter woodwind and string and a little harp in the background, right? A lot more tender in the instrumentation. And a shift in the key there makes it feel a lot brighter and hopeful now. And it's echoing the main melody already. It's beautiful.
And now I'm all alone again, nowhere to turn, no one to go to. Without a home, without a friend, without a face to say hello to. But now the night is near, now I can make believe he's here.
She is so inspiring to listen to every single moment that she sings. It's just like, it honestly makes my eyes teary to hear this utter perfection. She, first of all, has one of the clearest voices I've ever heard. I think this is what makes her a perfect Disney princess. But she's also singing pretty low here and still has tons of clarity in her sound. There's a few other things I want to talk about, but let's just go back and listen to the clarity and watch her mouth.
Without a home, without a friend, without a face to say hello to. But now the night is near, now I can make believe he's here.
We're gonna go back to this moment a few times because you have no idea how much goodness is packed into this very, very beginning. The clarity is partly coming from her tone, and it's partly coming from how much she is moving her mouth. It's like a Pez dispenser on crack. It's insane how much she moves her mouth. Just look at it go.
And now I'm all alone again, nowhere to turn, no one to go to.
But like that kind of mouth, like it's like jabbering. Yet she has this incredible, beautiful, silvery quality that she maintains the whole time. She has a line within this jabber mouth, right? And that line she's maintaining by continuing to funnel resonance to the same spot. So even though everything here is shifting like crazy, she has trained to keep it locked into the same, like a little like microphone essentially that's inside of her face. And it creates this focus point for her resonance. And that makes it feel continuously silvery, continuously beautiful. It makes us feel like we have one long, beautiful sentence instead of a bunch of different syllables. It's extremely impressive for how quickly she's moving and able to maintain that the whole time. There are so many different things inside of your vocal tract that are shifting to create a consonant or a vowel. There's just so many moving pieces. And to be able to so finely tune each of them to keep this beautiful line and clarity, that just, it's perfection. It's very, very hard to achieve. There's more. Let's go back though.
And now I'm all alone again, nowhere to turn, no one to go to. Without a home, without a friend, without a face to say hello to. Now the night is near, now I can make believe he's here.
Next part we're going to talk about is the timing of this entrance. Yes, there's tons of that jabbering that's happening, but it's very carefully timed. Sometimes she's right on the mark. It's like pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa, right? Other times, she's using a little stretch. She makes something that could feel very mechanical if you just look at the notes on the page, and she turns it into something that feels very naturally spoken. She lingers perfectly to give emphasis to moments, and we get a little lift in phrases, and then she'll drop right back into that rhythm. The phrasing and the way she's adjusting tempos here is just totally gorgeous. So one more time.
Without a home, without a friend, without a face to say hello to. And now the night is near. Now I can make believe.
I love that moment in particular. Now, we're going to keep going from this moment. But the next thing that I want to talk about and listen to, it's already been happening, is the way she disguises any sort of registration shift. There are times when she's in her chest voice. There are times when she's in her head voice. There's times when she's mixing the two together. And she's just so incredibly good at shading everything so that even I, on 50% of the notes in there, I'm not 100% sure which register she's using. It's nuts.
Sometimes I walk alone at night when everybody else is sleeping.
Whoa. For example, on Else, she has so much lightness in the sound, but it is pretty low in pitch, so it would be likely that she'd be in her chest voice, but the way she brought in this like really fluttery high, there's a fluffy brightness to it that feels like it's head voice. So she's mixing the two, obviously, but you know, is this a TA or a CT dominant sound? I don't actually know at that point. I could guess, but it would be a guess. And the way she's learned how to interweave those is just, it's phenomenal. That's definitely chest on that note.
Sometimes I walk alone at night when everybody else is sleeping. I think of him and then I'm happy with the company I'm keeping. city goes to bed, and I can live inside my head.
It's so beautiful and tender there. The way she's using her registers to color that just perfectly. She brings in strength yet tenderness in so many of those moments. And then on head, she gives this excellent, precise final consonant on the word head. And it's not a d, but it's not a t. It's this in-between sound that is, again, utter perfection. Listen to that one more time.
Head, and I can live inside.
I love this part.
On my own, pretending he's beside me, all alone, I walk with him till morning. Without him, I feel his arms around me, and when I lose my way, I close my eyes, and he has found me.
I get tingles listening to her in this part, and there's just so much of that quality that is totally beyond words or explanation, but I want to try to just explain one little thing she's doing that makes my heart so full of joy. And that is this inner smile that she maintains the whole time. You can see anytime she's ending a note, she goes into a smile afterwards. It's like, That can really help with that focus and threading of the resonance that I was talking about. But it also, she's hugging herself, but the tone quality makes it feel like she's hugging the entire audience. Let's go back to that. Just check out the way she keeps going to that smile.
Pretending he's beside me, all alone, I walk with him till morning. Without him, I feel his arms around me. When I lose my way, I close my eyes, and he has found me.
I love the way she just lingers a little bit longer on eyes there. Right? Again, pushing and pulling that tempo just a tiny bit. Oh, it's like the perfect amount of expression. And then the way she sometimes adds a tiny bit more of air into the sound versus a tiny bit more closure. It's like this tenderness and strength combination that she's just really carefully playing with back and forth to give us tons and tons of feeling. So good.
Feel his arms around me, and when I lose my way, I close my eyes, and he has found me in the rain. The pavement shines like silver.
Line and the way she goes up to like, it's just, it's so smooth, but it's so clear. You see how much her mouth is moving, and then that shift as she goes up to like with a little more head voice in there, it's just like, it's just filaments of silver throughout.
In the rain, the pavement shines like silver.
Your voice is like silver.
All the lights are misty in the river. In the darkness, the trees are full of starlight. And all I see is him and me forever and forever.
Did you listen to the two moments where she does a little toss off? Like a little, like almost a spoken off moment. It was on darkness, and I think forever and me, I think was the other one. There are two moments in there where she tosses it off, and that lets you know how she's able to be super specific or add a specific element of expression. She is so deliberate in both of those moments.
Lights are misty in the river. the darkness.
Right there.
The trees are full of starlight, and all I see is him and me forever and forever. And I know it's only in my mind that I'm talking to myself and not to him. And although I know that he is blind, still I say there's a way for us.
This is just the edge of it. I have goosebumps again. I've listened to this so many times, and she still gives me goosebumps and all kinds of feels throughout. This is her getting into some hardcore belting. She's just starting to get into it. And I love the way her mouth is so open, and yet it's still moving so much. Her lips are so active. Her jaw and her tongue are so active, yet her body is very still underneath. She has some elegant movements to go along with the story and help tell us, but overall her support system is calm, calm, and it's grounded. That's beautiful on its own. But then you have to remember that this is the same person, the same Jasmine. Listen to the warmth and the power of this tone, and then think about the like soprano just glimmer of Jasmine, and think about how this woman is able to form her voice to so clearly portray two different characters. And then you go on and you think, oh, she did Mulan as well. Oh, she also originated Kim and Miss Saigon. Like, that's wow. She's just got a stellar voice and stellar capabilities to create very, very clear characters. Let's go back here.
Forever and forever. And I know
love the strength.
It's only in my mind that I'm talking to myself.
I love that expression too. One other part, let's just bring it back a little bit. Listen to that line that she continues through without a single breath.
That I'm talking to myself and not
so
to him.
Here we go.
And although I know.
Oh, there's the breath. And then she continues.
Still I say there's a way.
I love that choice of breathing.
I love him, but when the night is over.
She keeps that in line so well. So the I love him, she brings that tenderness in. And then when you go up to that note on is over, that can be really difficult for singers. I coach plenty of people through this. This is, that moment is, you need to learn how to mix well to get that moment. And it's so clear. Her voice doesn't drop out of that focused resonance at all.
That he is alive. Of him, but when the night is over, he's gone. The river's just a river. Without him, the world around me changes. The trees are buried everywhere. The streets are full of strangers. I love him, but every day I'm learning.
There was yet another great example of how she's carrying some of these phrases over and taking breaths after a phrase has carried over. She's planned her breathing out superbly, and she's doing it so that she can carry emotion through. Even her breaths feel like they're still carrying our emotion through. It's just like when you want to talk about the best breath planning ever, just watch this. It's extremely, extremely good. I'm gonna go back again. I'll just go back to the same spot because there are so many moments in here that I counted at least three that just have that carryover of the breath that is just astonishing.
Without him, the world around me changes. The trees are barren everywhere. The streets are full of strangers. I love him, but every day I'm learning. All my life, I've only been pretending.
It's a great mix there.
Without me.
How do you not get teary-eyed in that moment? You're just like, oh, my gosh. I mean, it's fantastic writing. Okay, wow. I love that huge, sustained moment and then the clear space for the breath. But I just love the way that she fills that space with an emotional breath. This breath isn't just to serve the technique, it is to serve the emotion as well. It's, wow, beautiful. And then the way that she mixes on the top is just like, keeps the line, keeps the focus, and it actually pulls at my heart even more. Oh, one more time. Final consonant, right? Cherry on top. But let's go back to those I love him moments, because I love the way that each one she seems to gain a little bit more control back. She purposefully lets it feel a little wild on the first one. The pitch is like just not as specific, and then it gets more specific, and then it gets a little stronger and perfectly specific. And then that the final consonant is so good. One more time.
I've never known. I love him.
Right, not as specific.
I love him.
A little more, and then really clear here.
I love him, but only.
I love that applause. Add to that cherry on top, she is the first woman of Asian descent to play the roles of both Eponine and Fantine on Broadway. So she's just incredible all around. I hope you have some newfound appreciation for Leia Salonga, because holy cow, she has one of the best voices out there, period. In any genre, any time, it is just pure gorgeousness married to emotion, married to vocal technique, and I love her sound. If you want to hear some other absolute jewels that I think maybe you don't know as much about, I'll make a playlist up over here, and may you fall more in love with music every day.